Now, there is absolutely no doubt in my mind that both Jon Favreau, Dave Filoni, and George Lucas working together is really going to turn around Star Wars for the better, and it's really going to allow a good portion of the Star Wars fandom that walked away from the sequel trilogy to return and really just enjoy about what's to really come for this new Star Wars universe by Disney and Lucasfilm. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars updates. Also, by the way, guys, I am on Twitter at MikeZero1 if you guys want to go ahead and give me a follow on there. I do post a couple of entertaining things on there from time to time, and make sure to interact with you guys further. So what's really all the more exciting now is that not only are we getting very close to the Book of Boba Fett to be released on Disney Plus on December 29th, but we're also getting very close to the marketing run for the Obi-Wan Kenobi series. That, of course, brings back Hayden Christensen and Ewan McGregor to reprise their roles as Kenobi and Anakin slash Vader. So there's a lot of great things on the horizon for 2022, and the Book of Boba Fett, technically speaking, is a 2022 Star Wars TV show, even though it does debut on the 29th of this month. Most of it will take place in the beginning of next year. So, with that being said, of course, what's really exciting has everything to do with the fact of what Jon Favreau has been saying to the fans, how he's been a little bit more vivid about his thoughts, a little bit more truthful about what his experience was like over at Lucasfilm when Mandalorian Season 1 was being developed, when Kathleen Kennedy held a lot more creative power back then. And I think that obviously, given that Favreau, you know, he's been doing great work with a number of things. I mean, his acting in No Way Home is beyond expectations. I mean, I think that he does a great job in the Home trilogy, if you will. And he does a great job at writing and directing, you know, Star Wars material. And that's exactly what he's doing right now with these new Star Wars TV shows. So, with that being said, of course, however, what's really intriguing is that with Disney and Lucasfilm now focused on their new Star Wars projects like Ahsoka and Kenobi, it's described that currently both Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni are actively creating their new Star Wars universe with other creators as well to fulfill the Star Wars fandom, to enjoy what's coming next. However, in a recent interview with Jon Favreau, he was eventually asked about the biggest regrets that he has had of signing on to the Star Wars world through Lucasfilm. Jon Favreau went on to state that one thing I must say that really put me down, that I have to admit, is what, of course, that I originally was really pushing Lucasfilm and those over at Disney for a Luke Skywalker TV series and how it's an absolute must. Like, we must have to do this. This is something that needs to be done for the fans to really bring this character to life. I mean, who wouldn't love to see Luke's journey to becoming a master or watching him grow up throughout the ages? I had pitched this to Lucasfilm after I signed on for The Mandalorian before Episode 9 even dropped. And all, of course, they told me at the time that a Luke Skywalker TV series is far too risky to produce and is something that does not serve their interest at all. I kept pressing Lucasfilm that Luke is the center of the story. The Skywalkers are the heart of Star Wars. I will be honest, my heart kind of broke that day when they also told me that they believe that Luke Skywalker needs to be moved aside and not be a focus at all for the time being. I don't know if this had to do with the controversy of The Last Jedi or what, but they really didn't want me talking about a Luke series at all, and believed the character was of disinterest among fans. Fast forward to where we are now, I am so happy that I pressed them hard enough to do what we wanted to do in Mando Season 2, and I'm sure you all loved it too. And you are going to see tons more of Luke Skywalker, you just wait. When Favreau was also questioned about Luke Skywalker as a series, Favreau went on to state that, well, what I can tell you is that back then they wanted absolutely nothing to do with such a thing like that involving Luke. What I actually can and will say, I really can't confirm or deny if we are doing such a thing, but you are going to be very satisfied, I promise you. Additionally, separate from all of this of what Favreau said, this falls directly in line with a new series that is going to focus on Luke Skywalker and his Jedi students, dubbed simply as Star Wars Jedi Knight. The series is set to drop sometime in 2024 and announced at Star Wars Celebration in May next year. Favreau and Filoni are described to be heavily involved with this project, and though it's not going to be a strict Luke Skywalker TV show specifically, Luke Skywalker will be the main character of the show with other characters that are supporting him by his side that will be a part of his new Jedi Order. Lucasfilm is also planning to add in a young version of Ben Solo into the series to also add on another Skywalker in the mix to further fulfill Luke's journey to becoming a Jedi Master. So let me just stop right here for one second, because we obviously know that Favreau is pretty much a Luke, you know, fanatic. He loves the character. I don't know if you guys ever listened to him last year when he was really promoting the Mandalorian Season 2 and talking all about it, especially after the episode dropped involving Luke. Favreau said that that was his, you know, big character growing up when he was especially, you know, first getting his hands onto a lot of movies out there and kind of gaining his experience. He really loved the character of Luke Skywalker, and he kept saying how well written he was done by, you know, George Lucas and others associated with the original trilogy. I mean, they did fantastic work. And that's exactly why Favreau wanted to bring him back, because it's George's vision. And like John said, the Skywalkers are the heart of the series. And I never understood why Lucasfilm never really wanted anything to do with the Luke that we wanted. I'm sure that you guys remember that famous leaked image where it shows you like an office cubby in Lucasfilm where there's a little picture of Luke Skywalker tacked onto a cardboard wall and it has an X on his face. I don't know if that was a joke. I don't know what the context of that really was, but there was a Luke image tacked onto a little cubby area over at Lucasfilm with an X on his face. It seems like that it was a running joke among Lucasfilm employees that really disrespected the character and never really liked him. So Jon Favreau, you can tell he's on a mission. We've heard this time and time again, obviously, that the reason why Favreau even joined Star Wars in the first place is because he never really was satisfied with what Rian Johnson did with Luke at the very end of Episode 9, sadly. And I myself included. I gotta say, I mean, that theater experience was unlike any other before. Everybody was dead silent, people were kind of saying what happened and very confused and walking out of the theater saying, I'm not seeing that again. It was just very hard to take. It was a very interesting and yet very concerning experience coming out of the theater because you're like, what just happened, you know? You don't really process it immediately until you go home and, you know, you kind of process it further and you look up further reviews and what other people are thinking, and then it really settles in. So Favreau, I think he's doing a great job. He is on the road to success here. What he teased about Luke Skywalker does match directly with what we've been talking about of Star Wars Jedi Knight, which is going to be a Star Wars TV show in 24, all about Luke, Ben, the Jedi students, and even, of course, the Force and Lorsan Tekka. It's going to be quite an experience, and we will be learning more about that at Star Wars Celebration in, of course, May. So some months away from now, we're finally going to be able to get more info on that. Now, everything related to Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni working on Ahsoka, that's moving along very smoothly. A lot of sets are already being built. A lot of work is already being done with Rosario Dawson for her training to really completing the character of Ahsoka, because she's going to be doing a lot of her own stunts in that show. And that, to me, I think is going to be the most satisfying of all. So overall, guys, you know, I would love to hear what you guys have to say about what Jon Favreau said of how Lucasfilm really wanted nothing to do with Luke, didn't want to listen to Jon Favreau about a Luke series at all. And let me know what you guys think about all of that below in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time. Night to moon, we hear them moans again.